if you choose a different way or a different path to sell yourself or to sell your music, and it gets to the people, it gets to the roots, it touches them. This media who rejected you previously have no option than to go along with the masses. Their hands are tied. They just have to play.
I love Chris Rich.
This one, I know, be hype. In the organic movement, the energy, they go like that.
What happens on the streets, whatever happens in our homes, wherever we are in our corners, that's what we spit in our music.
You know, fake it. We did Kumerica. Asakaa to the tea.
Because first they told us to bring a clean version. You know, drill music, how can you do a clean version of a drill music?
On the street, so many things happen. So daily life, people pull up on people pull up on people, you know, that gang shit, you know.
Go parliament. Man, go parliament, go find money there, don't be here. Hey, shit.
Make up your fucking self, come as if for. What's the fuck on my leader?
What Asakaa did is skewed it and changed the narrative. So right now, the music is made in Kumasi and it's exported to Accra. It's a big thing.
Here lies Kumasi, the heart of Ghana's Ashanti Kingdom, rich in its culture of Adwa dancing, kente wearing, and kuntumure eating, a personal favorite. When people think of this place, they think of deep-rooted tradition, kings, queens, spirituality, gold rings, brass bands, and the rest of it. But when you pull back the curtain, you begin to see Kumasi has a side to it that defies everything its people have ever been taught.
Yeah, man, nobody can fuck you, go fuck you, oh, motherfucker, don't fuck me.
My life is movie, no director, pull up on gem, or surrender, team or time, obey commander, you know from my circle, you know in the sector. I don't talk much, my back is up for media, my mate, before I scatter. That's a matter if you're switching face first, not ever. Which one the selector? The 442 works better. I guess you want 10 takes is a
back. In this documentary, we'll be taking you on a journey through the Ghanaian drill music scene, otherwise known as Asakaa. Now let's listen to what these rappers have to say for themselves.
It's the meaning of the song. Okay, the title is Usua. It's probably I'm talking about a girl who is like, I'm trying to vibrate and all that. So I explain everything in the verses. So you get the chance to listen to the music. And in Ghanaian, when you understand you, you can feel the vibe. If you know Ghanaian, find a Ghanaian friend, they explain it to you. Still gonna feel the vibe.
This is filling up your peace. We have those monkeys. Drink coffee, wanna fall, better fall on your knees. Drink your mind with my cheese. Take a trip to the east. Come on, it's time, yeah, yeah.
From 1995, mid-1990s coming to early 2000s. Ghana didn't have a culture for young people. If you were born, the only music that you listened to was the one your parents listened to, what you came to meet. And it was high life and, you know, very, very old school high life. I remember when I was a kid, anytime you listened to music, it was the Lumbas and the Machididis and the Kodrenchis, who were all already big when we grew up. Hip-hop too was very prominent in Ghana. The Tupacs, the Biggie, the Jay-Z's and all that. We listened to that a lot. So it was either you were listening to your parents' music or you were listening to music that was coming in from America. Along the way, they tried to experiment and then put together hip-hop music and high-life music. And they mixed it together and then we created hip-life.
You are I make myself clear?
Yeah.
Do I make myself clear?
Yeah.
Then clap your hands like there was a million mosquitoes in here. Jump like you were so crazy.
People complained. People talked about it just like the way that they talked about drill. And it was a sensation. Like, this, it was crazy. Nobody had seen this before. And it worked. More and more people jumped on, and it has produced some of the best musicians Ghana has ever seen.
It's not easy trying to put a genre out there, but here's the situation, it has been done. These boys have placed Asakaa on the map. They didn't just create a music or a sound for someone to just listen to one or two. People have found passion in Asakaa. They are relating to the new genre. They have found a new path.
What is Asakaa? Is it like a religion or something? Charlie, tell me, what is Asakaa?
Asakaa is turning into a religion already.
It's gradually turning into a religion.
When we started doing drill, it was different. You get it? And it was so right that we had to, you know, give it a name and make it ours. It has similarities with a sound that we were familiar with. So when we heard it, it was like, wow, this is something that we could really express ourselves easily on. Did you get it? Bang, gang, gang, gang. Bang, gang, gang, gang.
Bang, gang, gang, gang. It's not about using the beat. It's about talking the trap shit. You get me? Like, people used to do the trap music. People used to talk on the trap music beat. But they were not saying the trap shit.
It's for anybody that really, really loves music. It's soul music. It's a lifestyle music. So whatever's happening here in Ghana is happening. It's happening in the UK. It's happening in the US. I mean, in various shapes and forms, but then it's still the same. You feel me? So it's connected. It's worldwide.
It was more easier to express ourselves or that kind of stories on that type of beat, because the beat, or you know, the Juby has this aggression, and then our stories are mostly aggressive and all that. So it just fits perfectly.
You have someone singing Afro beat, trying to sound Nigerian, that you are not Nigerian. You have someone singing hip life, trying to sound foreign, trying to sound like Recross, or trying to sound like Young Thug, but you are not Young Thug.
This is what we have been looking for. You know, Kumasi as a city has been looking for something like this for a long time. And this is it. You know, we've tried to look for other people in them, but we haven't really found like artists who are from here who understands the fabric of Kumasi to, you know, tap into that and create something out of it. And I saw that in them, and that was when I got stuck forever. They became like a drug one time, and I have been following them since.
That's 2019, way back 2019, after listening to Keisha Brekkie. Yeah, you know that song, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Keisha Brekkie. After listening to Keisha Brekkie, I had to do something like that, same thing, like same beat but different lyrics, you get me?
See the way I dey talk and flex these guys right now, big boy, I be gangsta. Put it on some glitz on toes, at the FD still tap back like a master. Two hoes in my crib, bro, say you won't try some, tell him I be faster. These ain't wanna talk too much, I dey run these down, go
biscuit. Reggie was selling phones on Adum. The person he was selling for, he called my phone. He told me like he have a boy there, he think he's good in music. So he want to connect me with the boy. They used to tell him to go to the studio, stop trapping here.
You release our day one, you get me right? Hey. When you say day one, hey. I started from here. Malcolm, I do Malcolm. It started from a do Malcolm. Don't get it twisted, that's right.
As I got to the fucking world. Yeah, everywhere. From Australia, Nigeria, Togo, everywhere. USA, Miami, worldwide, Brooklyn, everywhere.
I knew the music thing gonna work more than the phone thing, because the phone, I was struggling with it. Feel me, but for the music, it's a talent, you get me? Yeah, so I was just doing my thing, and finally we here, you get me?
There was a picture on that was trending on Facebook and Twitter. It was a bunch of boys wearing hoodies and jackets, and you know, the Accra people came at Kumasi people like, hey, look at them, hot weather, and you are wearing jackets and hoodies. Everybody who is from Kumasi who sees that will jump on it and defend it. They're wearing jackets because they like it. There's one phrase that's like, yo, akata nime huhuru. If you are akata, then you don't know hot weather. You know, an akata is like a gangster.
The akata in Kumasi is like the New York vibe. You know, he goes with a big baseball cap, goes probably with a jersey or a design top or his Nike Air Force. He doesn't miss. He dresses exactly like someone who's from Brooklyn, who's from New York, who's from Queens, but he's in Kumasi.
Kumasi and America, like, they have the same lifestyle, but maybe different environment, you get me? I didn't even know the Ghanaians out there, like, they fuck with Asakaa like that. But they were singing our song word to word. Everybody was loving it. But it was cold. I wasn't feeling the weather though.
That's by default. America and America, they default shit. We have similarities, so whatever the case is, but we're not copying. What we're saying, what they are saying, how we are living, how they are living, you know, it's different.
School, school. You know how we do. We don't hey, want to lose. Get up, get up.
That nigga look possessed. He look like a demon, bro. God damn.
Hey, you see that? Did you say life, living, entertainment?
Yeah.
One of the reactions that we did, yeah, with mm-hmm. the other Ghana group.
Okay, yeah.
I swear one of their bars was like, they're living something about life, they ain't living.
Oh, life.
So I don't know if these are the people they're beefing.
I can tell these boys were influenced by Pot Smoke, man. It just sound like, okay.
You see comments and all that, it's funny to us. We just laugh about it because it's like, yo, look what they say, yo. It's like yeah, it's funny to us, but once you decide to really understand what this whole movement is about, you'll understand. You'll know like, yo, this is no gimmicks. This is some, these boys are really, really talking facts.
I don't talk much, yeah. I just show action. When we pull up on them, AK-47 fashion. They're looking for street boy, Jibba dimension. I tell no cop this city, niggas can't show really much.
Very simply shot it, you know.
It's our daily life, you know. People have beef with others and those shit, you know. And we have, like, the streets, you know. That's what I'm representing, that's where I came from, so, you know. On the street, so many things happen. So daily life, people pull up on people, you know, that gang shit, you know.
On them, when we pull up on them,
It's a legend, you know. I rap it to the woo, you know. Yeah, Pop Smoke is a legend. He's one of those who influenced me to use drill beat, you know. I rap it to the woo. You know, we got similar voice. That's life, you know. That's nature.
You can't just be like the American because we are using our native language. If you are going to use the American slang, then it means we are doing the Chicago joke. But we are using our local dialogue, so we are changing things. There might be some similarities, but it can never be the same. Hope you are getting my point.
We are not shooting bullets, bro.
We're not shooting bullets, bro. Asakaa is spiritual, bro. We're shooting energy. What are you talking about?
No, no, it's not about violence, you know. We do no violence shit, you know. It's about having fun, you know. One love. At first, you used to have violence, you know. We used to have ups and all those kinds. But riders, we have changed all those shit and making, you know, it's fun, you know. Yeah, we all having fun. We all want.
I can't really control that situation where somebody outside there doesn't want to really do the homework and will just, you know, criticize anything they see. I can't do anything about it. No, I can't.
Well, I feel crucified on this chrome part two streets. Yeah, I got no hearts. On Chilean point, I tell no lies. Streaming so we don't socialize. They keep changing me in being someone entertaining, so I then we apologize. Counting the bitches, I'm fucking the bitches, I'm killing them switches, fulfilling my wishes. Niggas are leeches, I know it, I'm doing amazing. I'm killing my demons, my angels protecting my niggas, or help me just too crazy. I need me some praises, praises. Holy Jesus, I think I need me Christ. Fell in love, I need to rise. Done enough, I need to brag. Me name will and bear me why. Me name will and bear me why. We outside, I see your lights. All me to fly, miss my flights. All this pain, I think to side up two streets, yeah, I miss my guys. On Chile, I'm gonna tell no lies. Streaming so we don't socialize. Then you check the new deeds, someone had the tears, who are there, we apologize. Jesus Christ. Yo. Gang, you know, that's enough, man.
Hey! Wasia! You can't let the world know, like, this music thing is your thing. Like, that's my own philosophy. To sell music to people, you shouldn't let them know that it's your occupation. The music is a medium of expression. Do you get me? It's just like being a pastor. That shouldn't be your main occupation. Pastoral shouldn't be your occupation. You should have your own job.
Everybody wants to sound sane. You know, everybody wants to, you know, sound favorable so that they don't get into trouble. But these guys, they go with raw. Like, whatever it is that they experience is what they put together in their music. And mixing in with the drill, with the African flavor, you know, it's wonderful. So naturally, people will just cling to it. Boy, I ride, with gang. And my bread, I bake with them. School drop out, but I hit the pen. I love my flows. Free savage. Man, I'm back here, baby. Really, I'm back here, baby. She couldn't back here, baby. Truth sounds good in people's ears. It doesn't matter if it's an ugly truth or beautiful truth. It sounds good in people's ears. People want to know more. People want to understand more because it tells a story. It tells you about the things that you never, you know, knew existed. And they do that so well. They do it so well. I wish you could understand, you know, the words, the lyrics that they use. It's just wonderful. Jebad was raised in Baya Kaswa. It's a place around a place called Asafo. There's a market over there, and behind the market is this river. But now they've made it into like a big gutter. Where, what better word to use? I mean, person may use a criminal. A lot of nefarious acts goes on around that area. So it's likely for you to see people who are doing drugs and stuff like that. So Jebad was raised there. So imagine somebody who was born there and all the things that he has experienced in his life. Those are not things that you would want to be sharing with anybody, but not Jebad. He embraces it, and then he lets people know that, yo, whether you like it or not, that's where I was born, that's where I was raised.
Hello.
Cobola sitting at the front of my waist. Way back, my weed place at the base. Do you obey
any fat? Like, the thing is, we live and we write about it. That was our motto. Because we all came up on Wiz Khalifa and Tyrese, and that's what they do. It's like a lifestyle rap. You don't have to think too much. We don't stress to write. We write down our stress. That's it. We rap about how we live. So it's easy.
We have like thousands of people who live like us. The things they say, that's the combo, that's the street talk. That's how I express myself. I can't express myself any other way. If you don't understand me, this is not for you. Do you understand what I mean?
People were afraid. People felt like if they had to use these type of words to construct verses, people won't fuck with them, shit like that. They feel like it's explicit, they won't get radio plays. And we had like a stigma towards these type of things. So it started switching. We had to clear these type of things to make every artist who want to like think and write, do whatever. Now, I mean, I could see these kids, I mean, rapping about guns, shit. That's wild, though. Even with tradition, there's this like dynamism in tradition, culture. So we knew these type of things. We knew it won't really stop us from like, I mean, doing our own thing. Because even as traditional as it is, we are really not sitting. We give no fuck. Oh Lord, I'm a sinner. I'm stuck in my ways. I'm a dealer. I'm not cut out for back home. You know, she's my yes, she's vanilla. Gonna be me for dinner. Friend, oh, Melina. It was like one of the songs which I had like problems recording. I didn't think Hedy would jump on it. When they called me, Hedy was like, well, I was like, hey, Hedy, man. When I'm about to sleep, I just like put his tape on. I sleep with his tape. Nice job. Pay attention to details. You feel me? He pays attention to what he's saying, bro. Now fuck with that shit. I'm a sinner and a ruin. Robots got each your fingers, you keep it summer in the middle of the winter. Double back filled with paper, treat that Louis V bag like a printer. Link my hitter, he'll get that done. Then I might link Amma or might link Linda.
So at first they thought we were UK based artists, especially YGA, they thought he's a UK based artist. So later they found out, oh, these boys, oh, so they are Ghanaians. From Santa Zia, yeah, Santa America.
It's like a special because we do things for the street. We got love from the street. And I know the media, some of the media support us, but because we don't do things their way, some too don't fuck with us, you get me? But all the same, like, the street lovers, that's what's needed.
Because you know how the radio and the TV stations were? Unless you're already out there banging, people know you're popular and all, that's when they will host you. But when you're underground, you go there, they'll tell you that way we come, way we come in. They'll toss you every day, every day. To you yourself, realize that they ain't gonna help you. So you gotta do that on your own.
We even gave up, you gave up. Because imagine you are doing a music and the media doesn't want to support. It's not that they don't want to support, but they can't play your music. Because first they told us to bring a clean version. And you know, drill music, how can you do a clean version of a drill music? M.O.B. M.O.B. When you are bitches, bend your knee, bend your knee. Don't be stupid, don't be stupid. Out to peace, out to peace. Refuse to be broke, refuse to be broke. M.O.B.
As far as I can go is just send you my song through your email. I don't think they were rocking with that because they would have to come with some guala or something, you know, to grease them to, you know, get them motivated and all that. Payola. I didn't have that, so radio was really, really not my ideal target, you know.
When your song was played on the radio, you don't really know how many people listened to it or didn't listen to it, you know what I'm saying? You just hope that because it's radio, like a lot of people must have heard it. There was a point in my, you know, my music thing that I knew the my song was played every day, but you wouldn't know if people heard it or not, you get it, because radio has to be on rotation.
I remember when Akata 4 dropped, we had to wait. We had to wait and refresh. And we got 1K streams on audio, 1K on YouTube. Trust me, we're really happy. I love that. Hey. 1,000 views. We was really happy. We didn't know that she was going to get viral and get us a million. And now look at us.
Chinku. So basically, earlier I told you about a young man from Kumasi, how he dresses, how he moves, how he projects himself like he's from someone who is from Bronx, from LA, from California. Here, the term given to that person is called Akatani. So this one is like Akata for like a bunch of niggas. A bunch of niggas have gathered in the neighborhood, smoking. They got drunk, they didn't die. Early in the morning, they will go back to work.
I remember when the craze was on the internet, one lady here, her name is Anita, she hosts Showbiz here, and then she comes like, yo, Stan, I've been seeing this thing on the internet. What's it about? I was like, yeah, those are my boys, man. Let's bring them in. So I picked up the phone. I called Kwaku DMC. I called City Boy. I was like, yo, man, the thing, now everybody is onto it. Come on, hurry up. Come into the studio. People want to know you. They want to see you. And called themselves, and then everybody came here, about 20 of them. That was the first time I even saw a lot of, even though I know some of them, that was the first time I saw most of the young guys there. And what were they coming to do? Okay, let's see. So they started playing their music. They played Akata Four. They played Kwaku DMC's You Don't Know Me. And everybody was stunned, like, what? So we had this hiding here and nobody knew what it was. Like, this sounds very real.
Join us live on Facebook, LUV99.5 FM. Guys, can we do this together? How about we do this together?
The world is full of second-class cities, places which condemn you from the moment you're born, give you a reputation you didn't ask for, and an accent you can't help but speak with. Until now, Kumasi was one of those places. It's funny how the choices of a few hungry street boys, with nothing to their names other than a sick floor and a dream, could do more for their city than their politicians and royals. Consider that for a sec before you judge these artists.
You need to be a follower before you become a leader. That is the narrative in the Ghana music industry. Someone who has risen to the top wants the young and upcoming one to worship him or her. He wants you to work for him unpaid. He wants you to do services for him, services which are not all that pleasant. Before he thinks about helping you, females might be harassed for sex before a producer will help, before someone will even look at you to give you an opportunity, before someone will call you on stage. So if you choose a different way or a different path to sell yourself or to sell your music, and it gets to the people, it gets to the roots. This media who rejected you previously have no option than to go along with the masses. Their hands are tied. They just have to play.
yo.
It's not really easy from where we are, Kumasi, like America, where we are, for our music to blow worldwide. It passed Accra, now we're global. Like, it's been a while, like, it's been like 10 years since, like, Kumasi music pop off, like, since the Kenya time and those time, like, Kumasi music have been down.
Everybody we were seeing on TV was from Accra or Tema. Like, it was our worries, that was our biggest problem. We used to discuss it in the studio all the time. So everybody that's with us is somebody who wants to solve that issue.
We have to do something for our city, because if you go to USA, like,
We have New York people doing their shit. We have Chicago people doing their shit. You get me? You have DC people doing their shit. We don't, like, DC people ain't gonna say they have to go to New York.
You can walk around Kokobe and CJ, but do you get me? You can walk around anywhere in Kumasi and see somebody who is on TV. Do you get me? That motivates you. That makes you think like you too can become that. But when we were coming up, we had nobody like that. Do you get me?
But most of the Kumasi people, they go to Accra before they do music. Yeah, but that shit work. You get me?
People saw it as arrogance. But we were trying to tell them that, yo, there has been so many years in Kumasi where we the case, we never had anybody to look up to. Do you get me?
I don't go to Accra for fun. I passed that shit for me. Basically, I know how the system runs here. I mean, you getting to see me every day in the club, I mean, you won't make you come pay me for sure. No, I'm not doing that. So I'm not putting myself on that risk, man.
Yeah, they go there, they do business, and then come right back. You know, they make sure that they put it in their music, especially your dom, the one playing in the background. It's actually, even though they were talking about gang life and your friendship and gang life, they were also talking about Ashanti history. Said, "Kum apema apemba, kill 1,000 and 1,000 more will come." Don't get me wrong, Kumasi is a traditional place. This is like the traditional capital of Ghana. Anytime you mention Ashanti region or Ashantis or Kumasi, the first thing that comes into your mind is our tradition. Very rich tradition. But we've also found a way to kind of marry it with the cultures that we have copied from outside, and it has metamorphosed into something entirely new. This whole thing, this whole movement was kind of caused a revolution to make sure that, one, nobody gets to disrespect artists from here again, two, show people that it's possible, that you don't have to go somewhere before you can make it, and three, build one of the biggest music brands that this country has ever seen.
What Asakaa did is skewed it and changed the narrative. So right now, the music is made in Kumasi and it's exported to Accra. It's a big thing. DMC King Kong, he's mad talented, like, he's different. King Kong is different, like, he's a hard artist. He's hard as fuck. Sorry. But that's the only way I can explain King Kong. He's hard as fuck.
To have his customized Louis Vuitton shoes, probably made by Lucien Clark. You see? Top jeweler shit, the whole Africa.
The whole Africa.
Best jeweler artist. I wasn't the one saying that, bro. Check this shit out. Louis Vuitton, top jeweler shit. First nigga in Africa to have this kind of shoes. Ghana. Besides, bro. LV. Louis Vuitton. Check this shit out. Lucien Clark. And this shoe was signed by two people. Two fucking legends. Virgil Abloh.
That's Malcolm X, modern day Malcolm X, and Lucien Clark. And this is my name right there. Kweku. Fucking you, my nigga. I'm larger than you, all you artists here in Ghana. I'm the biggest influencer artist. And Louis Vuitton just gave me this kind of title. Official letter from Louis Vuitton. Let me read it. Dear Kweku, we hope you will like this Louis Vuitton A View sneaker signed by Virgil Abloh and Lucien Clark. I told you two fucking legends signed this. You didn't believe it. Look at this shit, bro. Straight from Louis Vuitton headquarters. Eh? Sincerely, the LV family. This shit, I'm gonna auction this probably in the next 30 years for probably $1 billion, bro.
Your relationship with Virgil, I know you guys had a very solid, strong bond. I know his demise has cost you guys a lot. Have you guys recovered yet, or you still haven't recovered?
Yeah, so that's
sure.
We are not very strong like that, but we chant to like.
You're finding a way to be strong.
Because he wouldn't want to see us being like crying or being miserable about his death, because he wanted to see us win. So, yeah. That's why we have not even made a tribute song to him. Yeah,
you guys have plans of putting together a tribute for him?
No, really. It will be like a celebration song.
Whoa!
Yeah.
You're gonna celebrate him instead. Yeah,
let me say this once again. R.I.P. to the Ken, Virgil Abloh. Man, I'm really sad. I won't lie to you. I'm really sad. Yeah. R.I.P. once again to Virgil Abloh, the Ken of the streets. He used to have plans for us. So we were just hoping and waiting for the better day. And I think, unfortunately, this happened. But, you know, one thing about Virgil Abloh, he always wanted us to win. He always wanted us to win. So we are not going to give up. We just have to make him proud.
When Virgil Abloh posted Suzy, that was when we started to know we have done it. So we popped champagne that day. Suzy was the first song we said Asakaa on, and Virgil posted it. So from then we knew, like, okay, we are on the right path.
A moment of silence for Virgil Abloh. Be a new light.
For sure.
Be a sun of four lights. Be a sun of four lights.
That's good, bro.
Jesus.
Don't talk much, JD. Shashi, Missy Goody. How much is going? How much is going?
I was just standing out on the mic. We're about to record the song. I think Suzy, yeah. And it just came. I was about to record my verse. Obroni, shit, this is hard.
Of course, the white man said Asakaa. When you see King Kong, you can ask him that question. The white man said Asakaa. You meet a 10-year-old, a 7-year-old, and you ask him or her, Obroni ne kan say. This kid will reply, Asakaa. Like, it's a phrase. And it's noted.
Asakaa.
I mean, there's no line of King Kong that doesn't happen in real life. Kutiba Majesa, like, if the police come, you run away. Which, like, so many people, young boys and girls, should relate to in Ghana and in abroad all over the world. When they see the police, they run.
The police will be, I've been on our nerves for long, especially my who grew from. In 2016, they killed my brother. Yeah, rest in peace to you. Yeah. They was chasing an arm robber, and it was late at night, and this arm robber dodged them. And they met my brother on the way, and they thought that was the guy, and they mistakenly beat him and shot him to death. They told us that My brother was sick and no, they didn't do anything. They took him to the hospital and he died of heart attack or something. They lied about his death, no. Always the poor people gotta suffer before they can make it in life. Yeah, really understand that. Really understand that. Really understand the struggle.
Watch out, man. I don't want anybody more. Watch out, man. I'm gonna fight. You're gonna fire. No, I'm saying you're gonna fire. You're gonna fire. Why? You don't worry people. Why? Because small, you go chop. How much you go chop? Go parliament. Go parliament. Man, go parliament. Go find money there. Don't be here.
Try to ask
a lot.
Try to ask a lot.
Shit.
If I walked into the trap house in like 2019 before everything, what would it look like? That's not to say it changed often, but what would I see?
You see a lot of hungry niggas. A lot of hungry but determined niggas. You know, got no food in the belly but still busting his verses out in the studio, going hard. You could tell that music was money, and it was just a matter of time. Nothing was like this, you know. It wasn't like this, because 2019, we never knew it was gonna turn up. And we don't work, we just do music. So where's the money coming from? You feel me? It was a whole lot.
You always felt that pain. Why is it like this though? As a kid, I think everybody out here felt that pain. It was like, yo, I mean, you're living in a shitty environment, man. It's like, this is not it. So we always like jealous like people overstate, you feel me? There's no system working. As a kid, you can feel it because, I mean, you have your own sense, you have your own reason. See, for a fight, this is not it though, bro. It's like going, helping it, like a tro-tro. I mean, this is not the right like vehicle to take you. I mean, we all knew for a fact though, but I mean, it is what it is.
Because bro, when you're starving, what the fuck, what's with bro? You don't give a fuck, you don't care whatever sound or whatever idea that comes in your mind. You're just hungry, you want to get food, bro. But we was trapping. We was finessing that shit, bro. We turned that shit into something different. Yeah, niggas know. Word to the boys.
Is it your dream to become a soldier, man?
You're already a soldier.
Yeah, warriors, what you are saying? Yeah, warriors already.
Shout out to Ghana Army, man.
You wanna join?
They have a house called the Trap House, where all of them are there. All they do is record music. You know, they outsource from their own selves. Some of them know how to shoot a video. This one can edit. This one can make beats. This one can, you know, master the beats. This one can do that. So it was kind of like a friendship thing, and they were all helping themselves. So when the time came that the limelight was thrown on them, they were already cooked. It was meal ready to be served.
You have to rebel. You have to rebel to see a change, to cause a change. The rebellious ones are causing the change, you know. Because you say don't do this, you say you're gonna do that. When you do it. And keep going, breaking the rules.
We've motivated the street. Yeah, we've motivated most of the people out there. Like, I don't really know how to say it, but with their hopes, you get me? Yeah, we've given them hopes and they can now do their thing. Like, anything that they're doing, they ain't gonna stop. They're gonna continue because they're gonna believe that one day it's gonna pop for them. Like, As it is for us right now, you get me?
We've literally employed, like, put niggas in a position where they can be full-time earners of whatever they put out, you know, earn royalties, you know, become legends, put on for their city, gave them confidence, like, yo, you can really do this. It doesn't matter if you're from Kumasi. I think everything is going to change with time. Yeah. And it will all depend on us to keep going, to keep, you know, setting the standards. Changing the rules.
I mean, why would you think Asakaa is not here to stay? Asakaa is here to rule. Asakaa will be dominant for over decades. Asakaa is here to stay. He's not going anywhere.
Let's
listen, stop documenting.
Me party, I'm in petty as I shake, boom, 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 boom,